station, we were under the British. So his father was the ruling chief. This is the father. The British gave him a mantle, so he's known as Sir Sultan. So under the British, he went to England to study. He studied a long time. He got his MA, BA from Oxford University in history. So after living a long time in England, when he returned, he didn't want to live with the father in the palace room and what the people in England, because he was Western educated, so he wanted to live independently with his one wife. You see, the father, grandfather, like the kings of old, in the days of old, they were allowed to have many wives.
Okay.
But he, being Western educated, he kept only one. So that was another reason he didn't want to live in the palace ground. So this house you are in now was built for him while he was crown prince. His father was the ruling chief. We don't have kings. The British left the Shan chief, you were under them. So we have altogether 33 small little states in Shan State.
Yeah.
Each with a hereditary chief. They are feudal lords. So they are not kings. So he was the crown prince. So this house was built for the crown prince in 1924. So in 7 years' time, this house will be 100 years old. That's why the people are helping to upkeep the palace because it belongs to history. You see, we were under the military, and we were not for over 50 years. We couldn't do any renovation, but now the country is free, and then the gardens are adapted further on San Suu Kyi, so now we have to upkeep the palace. So if you want to help, you are welcome.
Okay.
I'm allowed to charge $5 each. I don't, if you want to help, you can say at least $1. That's a benchmark. So, when the father died, he succeeded the father, and he and his one wife continued to live. But then just before Second World War passed, he was suffering from tuberculosis, TB. We had a time no cure, but we went to England, no cure, so when he returned, he was in his 40s, he died. And when he died, no children, so no one to take care of him. And then the British took care of the administration, but Second World War broke out, so the British were driven out of Burma by the Japanese. And then in 1945, when World War II ended in Burma, together with the Allies, the British came to take over Burma. And to drive the Japanese out of Burma, they dropped bombs around the buildings we want, so also we pass. Yes, it was gone. But this house was not touched by the bomb. Because as maybe you know, during the end of Second World War, the bombs that are dropped just destroyed the heavy bombs dropped. It doesn't spread. So this house was safe. So the British came back, they rebuilt the country. Then from 1948, Burma got independence from the British. And all the Shan chiefs, all 33 of them, they were reinstated. My father was the last ruling prince of Hsipaw, 16 months of peace of Hsipaw. But Hsipaw was without a ruler because he had no children to take after him. So Hsipaw needed a ruler. So what happened was his uncle, his father's youngest brother, happened to have two sons.
Okay.
So the two sons are his cousin. So no son, so the rulership of Hsipaw went to the two cousins. The elder one happened to be her husband in law's father. My father-in-law was the elder brother. And the younger one became the last prince who married Inge from Austria. So as even in Holland, where are you from?
France.
Even in Holland, in the days of old, the hereditary is the elder brother should succeed. But here, my father-in-law, although he was the older brother, he chose not to become the ruling prince because after independence, all the Shan chiefs, all the three of them, they found the Shan state government in Tangji, capital of Shan, which is
Have
you been to Tokyo?
Yes.
The Moon Festival.
Yes.
Very dangerous.
Oh, it's terrible.
Yes, yeah. Yes, no safety. It's very crude. So in Tangji, on the Shan chiefs, they found the Shan state government and the chosen head, prince from the neighboring state, and Donald's father, who were very good friends. So he was called to Tangji by his friend to help on the Shan state government. So that instead of becoming the ruling prince, he left from Tangji, became secretary of Shan state government. So he looks after the whole Shan state, a younger brother. And his husband became the ruling prince. So he doesn't understand. So the prince is my husband Donald's uncle. Rana is the prince. So when he became rich, as I told him, he lived here. So divine engineering in Denver, in the Colorado School of Arts. And while studying there, he met Inge Sargent from Austria. She managed to get a Fulbright scholarship. That's why she did all studying in Denver. So as students, they met in Burma after getting married in Denver, and did a teacher, or you can sit down. Where are you from?
Germany.
Yes. My time's in Tamara, right? So, he met the father-in-law in 1953 after getting married in Denver. The next year, the prince brought his wife to Sibor. This one, Sibor has an Austrian for a princess.
Has an Austrian?
Austrian for a princess.
Yes, princess.
A princess. So, no problem. Because, although Burma was used to the British, even that's nearly 100 years, so no problem. And also, Inge, after she got here, she changed herself. She adapted herself. She dressed like us every day in her costume and also learned to speak and write
Amazing.
She's still alive. She's still alive. As a new queen do, from Argentina she adapted to very much, except for that. So, Inge, after arriving here, 2 years later, she being the only wife, she got the title, the chief wife, which was Devi. It's a title of all Shan chief's wives. It means the great lady of the title. And because the people of Sibor, they can't call her by her Austrian name, Inge Sargent, so they gave her a Shan name, Sandi, literally translated means Princess Good Moon, or Good Moon Princess. And they had two daughters, Mayuri and her daughter, and Kenya. And Inge, arriving here in 3 years later, 1964, she had to be a farmer because 1962, 3 years earlier, maybe there, but Burma, we have been able to take over Kutita, staged by the army strongman, General Lee Whip. You see, he was ready for very secretly to seize the power. He needed an excuse. So what happened was, you see, all the central Burmese government, they were ruling the country there, parliament, democracy, ethics under them. They promised equal status, but ethics for life. They were suppressed, they didn't have equality as promised. So, end of February, they were planning, the next month, 2nd March 1962, at the parliament meeting, they were planning to ask for federation. Federation now practiced all over the world. Federation in each state, it is one elected state government, another Union of Burma government, so that they get equal status. That is what they are going to ask for. But General Naiman, preparing to seize the power, when he heard that the ethics were about to ask for federation before they could pass, 2nd March 1962, early in the morning, for sunrise, he seized the power. And starting from the president, prime minister, members of the ethnic leaders, attending the meeting in Rangoon, they were all rounded up, arrested, and put in prison. Half among the Shan leaders that were arrested, including the Sipo prince, his older brother, Donald's father, member of the Shan State government, and my father, prince of a neighboring state. So three of them were included with the detainees arrested and prison and surprised. And General Naiman, 8 o'clock, the very 2nd March morning, on radio, he declared to the country, he explained. He said, federation, which the ethics were about to ask for, he said it meant separation. That's all he explained. So with federation, the country is going to be separated. It's going to fall to pieces. So it didn't want that to happen. So we had to save the country from being separated. So that was his excuse for seizing the power. 2nd March, 1962, welcome. So up to last year, 2016, for over 50 years, nearly 60 years, your government was under military rule. So as you know, instead of developing, the Moors became the least developed in Southeast Asia under the military rule. But hopefully now, 1 year already, we have the elected government of the people elected in Nadi, headed by Aung San Suu Kyi. We hope to develop the country. Worked down to Rangoon so that once a week through the war office they could write and receive letters. But Inge was living here. I told you no palace, so they lived here, so this became the palace. And Inge, she arrived 54 up to 62, she got a flag of citizenship, but she didn't escape. So when the military took over, Inge was still a foreigner. That's why the gate you came in, soldiers guarded the gate. People coming in, they not had to give an account. Only when they gave her permission, Inge could leave the gate. So no, she couldn't get news from outside Sipo. But 6 months after the takeover, Ronald's mother, my mother-in-law living in Tongji, was allowed to visit Inge because their husbands are brothers. So when Inge heard that letters could be written, she wrote a letter hoping to get and gave it to the military here in Sipo. But the military refused to take Inge's letter because they told Inge, the Revolutionary Council did not arrest the Sipo prince. That's what they told Inge. But Inge secretly she received a note which her husband managed to smuggle out to her. It's in the book, page 175. In the German book, it has a postmark who's got marking the page. So she has evidence from the letter that her husband's mother got, written 2nd March 62, the very day he was arrested, and yet the day the military took him. So she has evidence. She knew from the note that her husband was arrested. But now when she went to give the letter to her refuse, he said he didn't arrest him. So that started her wondering, why should they deny his arrest? So living here under house arrest, she couldn't find out. So hoping to find her husband with the other detainees in the prison outside Rangoon, she asked for permission to be done. Permission given. So 1963, the next year with her two daughters, they left for Rangoon. And once in Rangoon, she could be searching. Later on, with help from the American, Austrian embassies and some ex-parliamentarian friends, secretly, they had to search because the military said they didn't arrest him. So they found out that the prince was dead.
Oh,
and
Prince of?
But up to now, they deny, so he's regarded as missing.
Nobody knows.
Up to now, nobody knows. So Inge, after finding out that her husband was no more, she knew as a foreigner it would be dangerous to continue living. So she, until she found out that her husband was no more, she knew as a foreigner it would be dangerous to live under the military government as a foreigner without a husband. So in 1964, with her two daughters, she had the two girls were born here. But with help from the embassy members in Rangoon, they somehow managed to help prove the two daughters were Austrian citizens. She could take their mother to Burma. And since my husband, my name is Burn, my husband Daniel is the nephew of the prince, so Inge met Daniel in charge. It was like over 40 years we've been living here.
Yeah.
But he don't live here, and he had left like a lot of educated relatives left from her because that very year Inge left, the military made the country into a socialist country. Everything became state owned. All of the big shops, up to one room shops, everything became state owned. No more work, yes. Government employee, and the pay was very low. So a lot of educated relatives left. If we had left to, we would be doing like that, then the house would be empty. And if the house is empty, the military would take over, and you won't be here today. And Daniel and I, it belongs to my father's family, and belongs to history. So we still only brought up our children here, children and our grandson, so it's still in our hands. It's my mother only foreigners, locals too. We call locals day and night because we are relatives of the Shan chiefs. They are afraid if they seem very friendly with us, they lose their job and so they don't come. But now, as you know, the country is free and the main government, so now we are not in locals to come there. So it's taking a lot of time because my husband is not here, he's in Tongji, looking after the family house.
Furious.
Yes, but so of us, Inge, she can sit down and be tired. So first, Inge, she went back to Austria to get in touch. Later on, she taught the director to educate her children in America for the future. So she took them back to them and she went to her husband to get here to live and work there. They're not allowed to come. It's 20 years military because after they left, 64, Now, she's in the
Yeah.